What's this? Oh. A glitchy ashtray. Can't save right now. There's two more. There's another one up there. Is this where I just came from? I think so. I was finding a new way in, but... let me just check. No, this is the same spot. Ooh, 25-37 euros there. I can't pass up that pomegranate. I don't know why. So how do I get down into the guy's place? I mean... I'm divided on whether to take all these guys down, if I can. You got two close together, that's gonna be hard. And now I'll have free reign of the place. It'll be easier for me to look around. Or try to find it without them seeing me. Right up here. There's two of them right together. So the one turns and then the other one turns. Where is he? Around here? Oh, he moves quickly. Whoop!
I know you're in here.
Crap. Oh, he's tough.
Yeah, don't stop.
Can I? Thank you. They're pouring out of there. Oh, take care of you. Oh, that. Alright, don't be near them when you get them with that. Alright, I'm back here. This is where the two walk. He's walking away. If that one didn't see me, it would have been just fine. Oh, I only see one now. Oh, there's the other one. I don't know, I'm tagged. Ah, crap.
Drop any weapons and come out! Fuck was that?
Okay. Does this mean the others will still come? Because he found a body, but I don't know if he told others. There's someone else looking for me. No idea where he is. Doesn't sound close. How do I get down to this place? Can I break through a window? I mean, it's not very sneaky to just break through the window. Trouble. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't see a way to drop down. That's not working.
New magazine detected. Message to user. Thanks, Choom.
Message to user. Thanks, Choom. No problem, Choom. I mean, you'd think maybe I could get through one of these vents. Break through the window. Because I just don't have the technical ability to get in there, so... Very often there's another way. Check the other side, I guess. I don't know who that is, where he's saying that. Oh, this is a... Oh, okay. Good to know. I'll interrupt the brain dance momentarily. Oh, hey. Nice. €2,250, huh? Trying to sound closer. I missed something over here. Yeah, I've got that before. Interrupt brain dance.
Wakey, wakey.
What? Who the hell are you?
What you'd find more interesting is who sent me. Remember your little science experiment with the Red Ochre Clan? The family send their regards.
I do. I remember well. It was an integral stage in my research. You see, we're working on new antibiotic...
Oh, please.
Yeah.
Gonna feed me the story of how sacrifices must be made in the quest to save humanity?
I'm not. I know people like you. Hired plenty myself. And I know you won't let me go. But at least let me back up the test results for future application. These nomads, they're gone regardless. Let their death serve a purpose.
No, you die here now, sorry.
This antibiotic of yours, I know for damn sure, most of humanity couldn't afford it. I know its main purpose is to fatten your holiday bonus. Fuck your data. You die here and now.
All right, how do I get out of here? Oh my God. Like, threw her into the wall. I exploded her or something. What the hell? Nightingale, work in progress. From Joanne Koch to Biotechnica R&D. Dear colleagues, Dr. Isaacson performed an autopsy on the deceased nomads. There is no doubt that the cause of the test subject's deaths was electromagnetic overstimulation. Furthermore, Dr. Isaacson discovered several other abnormal changes, such as drastic neuralgic growth, for example. Needless to say, for the sake of the Nightingale Project's future, information regarding such side effects should never leave the company. I take this opportunity to remind you of the NDA you have signed and of the penalties that await you should you break it. Joanne Koch. Ugh. Like inside my arm or something. All right, so let's go back the way we came. These are still asleep, I hope. Never mind, I don't need that. That guy's in the lobby. It's saying for me to escape. Go up? No.
Gonna investigate.
Uh-oh. But we're so high up, I can't jump off that roof.
Come on out. You're not in trouble.
Good investigating.
NCPD. Done. Whew.
Got work, Joanne Coke bit the dust.
Coke? That's how you say it?
Nothing I love more than working with pros. Gig's closed. The Eddies are on their way.
They didn't hide bodies, though. They're gonna find him eventually. Well, yeah, this thing. I am gonna do this soon. Don't worry about that. Not play it safe. I mean the map 10 Palen whatever. Yeah. That one. Okay, so as far as here, we've got an assault in progress right there. A side job here. I don't think we're gonna find anything like of high difficulty anymore. It's all gonna be low, very low, or sometimes moderate. It's all low, very low. So, I guess it's like story mode. Sort of. It is tricky getting the stealth down right. I failed that one time. And I would have kept failing and just fought my way out of there, but I got killed. Because you can't explode the mech when you're near the mech. Found that out the hard way. Clock's ticking. Alright, so I'm going to follow up. Oh, let me get away from these people some more. Not sneaking. We have a little bit of time left. What happened here? And get up there. Well, we got some light here for a little light reading. Stand by, guys. I'll be right back. Quark. So the rest of the episode is going to be me reading through these shards, so... If you want to tune out now, go ahead. Juice. Top 8 dangers. Didn't I read this? Juice, the animal's favorite drink, a miracle elixir. The dream come true of every scrawny twig-limbed skeletor that dreams of having boulders and chesticles. But is it safe? Apparently it poses particular problems for men. 8 problems, to be exact. Here are the top 8 dangers of using juice. It's like a YouTube video. 8. A temporary increase in sexual ability followed by a sharp decline. Men are also at risk of priapism. Perpetual erection. Sounds shimra, but it could be painful. 7. Gynecomastia, i.e. enlarged breasts, often irreversible. 6. Balding on the head, but increased hair growth on the chest, back, stomach, and legs. 5. Changes in your skin, such as acne on the face and shoulders. 4. Kidney problems resulting in increased protein content in urine. Kidney scarring may be an indication of focal segmental glomerulosclerosis. Oh my god. How do people say words like this? 3. Muscles may grow asymmetrically, often leading to muscle weave tearing. 2. Prostate cancer. It'll hurt every time you take a piss. 1. And finally, the winner, liver failure resulting in jaundice and pruritic rash, and even fibrosis and cancer of the liver. Still interested? Not scared of the risks? Well then, good luck. Liberum Arbitrium review. Right. This is the review of the video game, I think. We found in River Ward's sister's son, so his nephew. Pretentious banality dunked in a sloppy symphonic sauce. Chromatic rock pretender at worst, caricature at best. Oh, so from not a video game, an album. Okay, sure, heavy riffs, check, unique vocal growl, check, essence of the 60s, check, but all of it gets drowned out in a flood of cliched dark tones that's too much for even neo-kitsch gen fans to swallow. There's no punch, no curb stomp of edge. Honestly, by the standards of the genre, it's a lullaby. I'd love to put this review to bed, on an unmarked grave, but I haven't even talked the lyrics. They made me roll my eyes so violently I sprained an optic nerve. Nowhere was it worse than in the titular track, Liberum Arbitrium, the band's anthem about the violations of human free will. What's the enigmatic evil depriving us of what matters most in life? Yes, you guessed it, corpse. I yawned so loud I put the singer's growl to shame. The latest album from Tainted Overlord is nothing short of a chromatic rock mix you burned a decade ago, erased from memory, then found wedged under your couch next to a dusty Carlson's burger. Diehards of the band will find something to scratch that itch, but anyone else looking for a fresh sound is better off blowing a concussion grenade in a cookware outlet. Dist. Review, Bloody Bout 7, What Went Wrong? Alright, this is about a game. Just when we thought Macroware was done putting out unfinished games, we get this piping hot plate of spaghetti code. Frankly, I don't even know where to start. From the story mode, which feels like it was cobbled together from the half-baked ideas of six writers working in different time zones, to the non-intuitive tutorials, to the ridiculous log that had me making a fresh cup of coffee between each punch, and finally to the head-scratching localization foul-ups. Honestly, the dialogues make no sense in any language. What the hell were they originally written in? Swiss? Net Shamans. Pacifica has everything you would expect of a place with such an infamous reputation. Shady locals, sketchy shops, and the presence of the enigmatic voodoo boys. Enigmatic how, you ask? After all, it is not uncommon for close-knit gangs to harbor secrets about which the rest of the city is completely unaware. And the voodoo boys are no different from any of those groups, right? Now ask yourself this, have you ever witnessed a gang shootout? Probably more times than you can count on two hands. And who was there? The Valentinos, Tiger Claws, Maelstrom, Sixth Street, but never the Voodoo Boys. Never them. Depending on who you ask, you will hear different stories and opinions about this reclusive gang. They are the de facto leaders of Night City's Haitian diaspora. They slaughter black roosters in blood sacrifice. God only knows where they get them. Right, because birds are outlawed, right? They commune with their ancestors through prayer. They summon ghosts and allow them to assume control of their bodies. They bring pain, disease, and suffering to their enemy's doorstep with the help of occult voodoo dolls. Perhaps you think some or even all of these claims are just hollow rumors, but can you be so sure? Some say they have witnessed voodoo boy netrunners in the deep net. Surrounded by vampires and leviathans, they traverse these strange depths of cyberspace, both more beautiful and dangerous than we could ever imagine in real space. Their objectives there are known only to themselves. So who are they? What are they searching for? What is their plan? In the end, perhaps we shouldn't ask ourselves these questions. Indeed, some secrets are better left undiscovered. Cyberware controversy in football? Never before in a single night has a crowd snapped so abruptly and so frequently between euphoric cheers and deafening silences. The most recent match between the Night City Corsairs and the San Diego Shredders ended in overwhelming victory for Night City. But it was another team that stole the spotlight. Trauma team paramedics airlifted out a record 7 players during the game due to a potentially life-threatening injuries. Three still remain in stable but critical condition. The game's unusual spike in injuries was the result of a months-long feud between the two franchises that had hit a boiling point. Shredder's head coach, Darnell Irving, has repeatedly accused the Corsairs of breaking league rules by allowing players to equip military-grade cyberware. Corsair's organization representatives have refuted the allegations, claiming the rules contain no such clear-cut cyberware guidelines. Night City's head coach even went so far as to say that San Diego, quote-unquote, would be wise to make the same upgrade instead of crying like babies whenever they get their asses kicked. What he doesn't mention, however, is that the Night City Corsairs have a sponsorship deal with Night Corp, granting them exclusive rights to equipment designed in Night Corp's top-secret football science lab. Salt in the wound. Of course, I'm persuaded the San Diego faithful have argued to the league that the use of military-grade technology is damaging to the game's integrity and future. Football analysts and commentators, on the other hand, have dismissed the controversy, saying that the arms race mentality has always been pervasive in sports. Their case in point, the 2064 Night City Marathon. In a record-setting and uncontested victory, Austrian runner Dominik Baum blazed past favorites from the Czech Republic and France because of Vienna's close partnership with Zeta Tech. Interview with the Queen of the Metro Jungle. Here's a tasty morsel for all those fascinated by the secrets of the Night City underbelly. After months of stonewalling and upsetting threats, I finally arranged an interview with a member of the Animals gang. We met in a bar on the far west side of Pacifica. When she pierced my eyes with her own slitted pupils, I thought back to those old wildlife docuvids I used to watch and realized I must have felt just like those gazelles did when ambushed by a pride of lions. Interviewer, truly, thank you for agreeing to this interview. They didn't mind your pack? Herd? Anonymous animal, burst of laughter. They don't give two rat, beep, do what I want, excuse me, when I want. They got a problem, and them can square up. Me and them can square up. Thing is, I know they all too scared to try. Are all of the animals guided by this survival of the fittest principle? Bet your ass. I said it there. Oh, it's the S word I didn't say. If you ain't hard, you're a blood bag waiting to pop. That's why we bulk. Roids, modified horse growth hormones, at least half a day in the gym. Interviewer interrupts. Wait, confused pause. Did you say horse? Animal laughs. What, you think animals is just some cute name? Humans are weak by nature. Hippos, though, they can eat a whole croc. Can you? And dude, tigers? 4-inch canines and 700 pounds of pure majesty. And that's who we are, the alpha beasts of Night City, kings and queens of life and death. You sound like a poet. Say that again and you'll be wearing a jaw like a hat. Interviewer laughs nervously. Yes, well, is it true that you reject the use of cybernetics? Yes and no. Co-processors can be hacked, so we steer clear of those. But retractable blades, metal claws, titanium jaws, leopard print, tech leather, that's another story. Fascinating. Well, I won't keep you any longer, so let me thank you for your time today. Is there anything else you'd like to express to our readers? Don't screw with the animals, Night City. We'll rip you apart, chew you up, and spit out the bones. My. The Wall. Why does a wall separate South Carolina from its northern sibling? NUSA officials will tell you it's about ensuring freedom and safety. After all, the first things that come to people's minds when they hear North Carolina are shifty nomad families, illegal immigrants, and violent criminals of every stripe. They say the wall is necessary for customs officers to prevent smuggling, and we're not just talking drugs. Markets on the rise for trafficking include illegal cyberware assembled in old hangars, biotech equipment, and precious items from orbital stations and lunar colonies. And I understand that. I can even understand when you cross the border, you willingly waive your right to privacy from having your face scanned and registered to your car, being tracked by heavily armored drones that transmit your real-time coordinates to a rapid response defense team in orbit, all on the off chance you're in fact a terrorist. For the split second that you go through the security gates, Militech, or whoever won their bid to secure the wall, won't allow you to forget that you're in a potential war zone. And that's exactly what the wall is, a reminder. A reminder of how fragile peace and the independence of our city is. As a Night Citizen, I see the wall relatively frequently. Thanks to that concrete monstrosity, there's really no other way to describe it, I always bear the cost of peace in mind. Is that good? Bad? You decide for yourselves. Let's make sure there's nothing else under this one. Leaflets, I read. People of Night City Era? Peter Sampson, Person of the Month. I'm just an ordinary city boy, read the untold insider scoop. Recipe for success, money, cars, and fine suits. 1,000 ways to enjoy sex. A Peter Sampson tell-all. Okay. World, I've read it. Chemicals, the invisible killer. We've long known that the AVs crisscrossing our skies are busy dumping harmful substances in the air, such as aluminum, carbon dioxide, sulfur trioxide, and sulfuric acid. Really? Studies have also revealed the presence of dead red blood cells and E. coli, as well as sodium chloride, table salt. Okay. Now, you don't need a degree in science to know the harm these substances can wreak on the body. We found that sulfur compounds can lead to cancer, heart disease, and other illnesses arising from a weakened or even damaged immune system. They can also lead to spontaneous dental hydroplosion. Explosion of water coming out of your teeth? Is that the, and acute meningitis. Okay. Sheet metal and you. You're a guide to auto body repair. Just like you take care of your own body, so too should you take care of your favorite four-wheeled friend. Many ask, when should I pull the trigger on making bodywork repairs? Simple answer, when it's no longer functioning at factory quality. Typically as a result of collision damage, corrosion, damage from firearms, or general wear and tear. But before you dive straight into the repairs, you should always first conduct a comprehensive survey of the damage. Not only damages nature, but also the damaged part's core function in the vehicle as a whole should be thoroughly considered before choosing the best repair method. Remember, always be sure to have the right set of tools handy before you begin with the repairs, and if there is any organic material still present in or on the vehicle, e.g. blood, bone fragments, etc., always make sure to clean it thoroughly first. Do yourself a favor and don't make your job more difficult before you've even started. But don't forget, quality sheet metal is the most important piece to the car repair puzzle. Follow the link at the end of this manual to check out the shop Martin's tinware for high-grade materials at unbeatable bargains. Well, there's no link, so I can't do that, can I? Archive conversations. There's a few things here. Other. Manipulation. Easier than you think. The most fundamental yet effective manipulation technique is what we call undermining. For the manipulator to get the target to do what he or she wants, the target must first accept the manipulator's option as true or valuable. This is easiest to achieve by making the target feel inferior through harsh criticism. The more accurate, the better. The target will begin to yearn for praise from the manipulator, becoming more open to cooperation, that is, manipulation. The joy of influence. Five simple rules. 1. Exude authority, speak with conviction in absolutes, and never ever lose confidence in yourself. 2. Practice the rule of reciprocity. Make sure people always feel like they owe you something. 3. Be unavailable. Make yourself seem like a very busy person whose time is more valuable than theirs. Even a meeting is a sacrifice. 4. Demand engagement. Remember, if a client is forced to give you enough attention, backing out will be even harder. 5. Make them like you. People like people who are similar to them. Never forget it. Never forget it. The consciousness guide. Consciousness curse, sorry. Man dies the way he was born, soft, weak, and helpless. Death, the one certainty in this universe of chaos, can be both a tragic end and a release from suffering. It can come as an unexpected twist or as a beautiful crowning counterpart to a life well lived. The curse we face as humanity, the only living beings in constant awareness of death, is our inordinate focus on the fact. How much happier is the life of the gazelle that escapes the cheetah's clutches, knowing that it evaded death once and for all, than the poor soul living out his days knowing each step inches him closer to the void? The cult of Santa Muerte. Who is the Lady of the Night? We don't fear death. What's to be afraid of? Santa Muerte is a good friend, a close companion. We know how to talk to her, and we know when there's no more room to negotiate. This is one of the first responses I heard while asking residents of Vista del Rey about Santa Muerte, sacred death. Her worship, officially condemned by the Roman Catholic Church but heavily influenced by its rites, is unusually popular among those of Mexican origin, especially in Night City. Few realize that the cult finds its roots in ancient times. It's highly likely that Santa Muerte first arose as a fusion of the beliefs of the Aztecs, Mayans, and other indigenous residents of South America with those of the Catholic Church first brought to the continent centuries ago by the Spanish conquistadors. It's one of my favorite words, conquistador. Our Lady of Holy Death, also known as Lady of the Night, Señora de la Noche, is a fascinating deity. Her wide-ranging devotees include prisoners, gangsters, and drug dealers, but also police officers, prostitutes, and others who work under the cloak of night. In other words, anyone whose life is in constant danger. Even at the turn of the 21st century, persecuted members of the LGBT community would also pray to her. Santa Muerte offers her protection to anyone who asks for it while leaving the appropriate offering on her altar. Rum and tequila, fruit, cigarettes, candy, or flowers. Interestingly enough, it is believed she does not distinguish between morally sound and morally questionable requests. Her worshippers pray for health and happiness, but also revenge or the death of their enemies. Everyone, no matter their request, must remember one thing. Every prayer offered comes a price, carries a price. If you don't pay, Santa Muerte will take someone close to you, and she would have every right to do so. Santa Muerte is not just another chthonic goddess of the underworld. She is the saint of the rejected, the excommunicated, of those who feel somehow unfit to ask God directly to intervene. It should come as no surprise, then, that so many Night City residents consider her their patron. The Holy Bible, Old and New Testaments. Ecclesiastes 9. For all this I lay to my heart, even to explore all this, that the righteous and the wise and their works are in the hand of God, whether it is love or hatred, man doesn't know it, all is before them. 2. All things come alike to all. There is one event to the righteous and to the wicked, to the good, to the clean, to the unclean, to him who sacrifices and to him who doesn't sacrifice. As is the good, so is the sinner, he who takes an oath as he who fears an oath. Doesn't seem fair, does it? 3. This is an evil in all that is done under the sun, that there is one event to all. Yes, also, the heart of the sons of men is full of evil, and madness is in their heart while they live, and after that they go to the dead. 4. For to him who is joined with the living, with all living, there is hope, for a living dog is better than a dead lion. 5. For the living know that they will die, but the dead don't know anything, neither do they have any more a reward, for their memory is forgotten. 6. Also their love, their hatred, and their envy has perished long ago, neither do they any longer have a portion forever in anything that is done under the sun. Really. Chrome and You, excerpt from a novel by Anonymous. We are temporary, expendable, replaceable. The sooner we come to realize that, the better. After all, our days on this blue speck of dirt are numbered, are they not? Very strictly numbered. In fact, thanks to this plethora of technology that surrounds us and permeates our bodies. But that's all fine and dandy, isn't it? Just know this. Only a few decades ago, people were still attached to their body as something that justified their existence and foregrounded their identity. Know this. Less than a century ago, implantation was still considered to be invasive, an attack on our fundamental physical connection to reality. And now? Your body is only a spare part, your existence is upgradable, and your here and now is constantly getting outdated. So who are you? You're temporary, expendable, replaceable. Feel that, know that, and you'll regain your freedom. Well, I don't want to be replaceable. Alright, that's it. I read them all. Should I get caught up with some of this? I'm not going to read the vehicles. It says new for weapons, but there's nothing here. Biotechnica. Biotechnica is a corporation specializing in genetic engineering and biotechnical, pharmaceutical, and microbiological research. It was in Biotechnica's labs that the world's leading specialists first made the breakthrough discovery that brought the world back from the brink of a fuel crisis. The discovery? CHOOH2, a fuel based on synthetic alcohol obtained from genetically modified wheat. This patent made the Corporation, a major player on the market. To this day, Biotechnica retains exclusive rights to the product and complete control over the fuel market. Its other major field of business is food production. Large companies such as All Foods also fall under the Biotechnica umbrella. Alright, so that's that. See, I read it and it's not going away. It still says new. The city and surrounding areas. Triple Extreme Gym. A former paint factory in Pacifica, Triple Extreme Gym is now a fight ring belonging to the animals. Fighters clash in an enormous vat that was once used to mix paints. The post-industrial interior lends the show a unique atmosphere and interesting acoustics. La Katrina. A Valentino... Yeah, we hung out in there. A Valentino-run funeral home, La Katrina is a completely legal enterprise in the eyes of both God and state. And the caskets are absolutely positively full of bodies of the deceased, not drugs and guns. You could go and see for yourself, that, though that would be a shocking display of disrespect. I guess the Valentinos wrote this entry? Fixers, Dino Dinovic's place. Oh, right, I forgot to look at that after hanging out. Dino is accepting visitors and is posting up gigs in his own bar, Electric Orgasm. He came up with that name himself, which tells you more about him than the bar. That said, the place has its charm. Districts. Nothing new. Subdistricts. North Oak. North Oak is the newest district in Night City. It's also the richest. Freedom from poverty and gangs. Now, that's what you call luxury. It's hard to believe, but 50 years ago, this was just a rocky hill hemming the city in from the northeast. After the nuclear bomb went off at Arasaka Tower, almost 8,000 desperate Night citizens moved to higher ground, putting up corrugated tin roofs and a la shantytown. Over the next few years, the hill became something of an independent district, its poverty and duct tape houses a grim reminder of the past. Finally, in the 50s, the Night City Council, sponsored by corporations, decided to do some spring cleaning, officially waging a war against crime. The North Oak slum was forcefully evacuated and bulldozed, only to boost the city's priciest real estate soon after. Today, North Oak houses the city's wealthiest elite, corporate execs, venture capitalists, actors, musicians, living next door to their producers, and rock stars such as Carrie Eurodyne. All of North Oak is dotted with spacious villas featuring their own microclimates and manicured lawns. North Oak is the city's very own Elysium and every Night citizen's dream neighborhood. Vendor hubs. The View. A shopping mall between Corpo Plaza and Glen, offering lovely views of the nearby park and port. If you have the Eddies for top-shelf tech, weapons, clothes, and restaurants, then The View is the place for you. Find everything you need under one roof, draped in luxury and tasteful elegance. And that's it, except for the weapons, which I... Well, not weapons, vehicles. So I'm going to read all these in a separate episode, but I don't know when. Well, we have more stuff to do, of course. There's always more to do. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.